We want to simplify the cube root of negative 27 and the fifth root of negative 32. Because the number underneath the radical or the radicand is negative, these may seem more challenging. But as long as we remember that the product of an odd number of negatives is still negative, we'll be able to simplify these. So for the cube root of negative 27, if we ignore the negative sign for a moment and recognize that 27 is a perfect cube because it's equal to 3 times 3 times 3, and if we made these factors negative, the product would be negative 27. So we can rewrite the cube root of negative 27 as negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3. And because we're taking the cube root of this, and we have three equal factors, this will simplify to just one of the factors, which is negative 3. Of course, if we wanted to, we could rewrite this as the cube root of negative 3 raised to the third, and recognize that the cube root and this exponent of 3 would undo each other, resulting in negative 3. But again, the reason why the cube root of negative 27 is equal to negative 3 is because negative 3 raised to the third is equal to negative 27. So for the fifth root of negative 32, again, ignoring the negative sign for a moment, if we wrote the prime factorization of 32, it's equal to 5 factors of 2. And if we made these 2's negative, the product would be negative 32. So again, we could rewrite the fifth root of negative 32 as 5 factors of negative 2. And because the index is 5, and we have 5 equal factors, this simplifies perfectly to one of the factors of negative 2. Or again, if we wanted to, we could have written this as the fifth root of negative 2 to the fifth, and the fifth root and the exponent of 5 undo each other, resulting in negative 2. Again, the reason why the fifth root of negative 32 is equal to negative 2 is because negative 2 raised to the fifth is equal to negative 32. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.